वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ हेल्म ऑफ साइंस। सो एज यू कैन सी, वी विल डिस्कस ऑन डॉपलर टुडे, एंड देयर विल बी टू टॉपिक ऑफ डॉपलर, एंड देयर इज डॉपलर इफेक्ट इन साउंड, एंड एज वेल वी विल डिस्कस ऑन डॉपलर इफेक्ट ऑन लाइट। सो प्लीज वॉच द वीडियो टिल एंड एंड स्टे विथ अस, कीप वॉचिंग हेल्म ऑफ साइंस। सो at first we need to know what is Doppler effect. So when we say Doppler effect, we must know that, or we must know about a fact that there must be a relative velocity between the two objects, that is, one is observer and one is source. Source is, this is a source, source of sound. And here it is an observer. So when there is a relative velocity, between source and observer, there is a little change in the frequency of the source. The source will have a constant frequency, suppose nu zero. And if there is a relative velocity between the source and the observer, there will be a change in the frequency, and this effect is known as Doppler effect. This is the Doppler effect, change in frequency. So whenever an object or a source or an observer is in relative velocity means, suppose the observer is coming towards the source, or the source is coming towards the observer, or the source is going far from the observer, or observer is moving far or moving in distance from the source, then as there is a relative velocity between these two, there must be a change in the frequency of that sound emitting from that source, and this is known as the Doppler effect in physics. So as we are saying that there will be a frequency, so we need to know that not only in sound, but there will also a Doppler effect seen in light sources. We will later discuss on the light Doppler. At first we will discuss now on the Doppler effect of sound. So here is some formula. To calculate the change in the frequency, suppose the change in frequency is written in nu 1. So what will be the change in frequency due to this relative motion or relative velocity? Let's see. First we need to know that when there is no relative velocity between the source and the observer, there is no change in the frequency, that is, there is no Doppler effect. It could be possible in two ways. One, the source and observer both are in rest, or the both source and observer are moving in the same direction with the same velocity, then the relative velocity between these two will be zero. So there will also no change in frequency. So at first we can make the formula like this. Our new frequency, nu 1, will be equal to nu 0 multiplied by some constants or the some parameters. Sorry. So how to define or how to get those parameters? Suppose the source is moving towards the observer and observer is fixed here, rest, observer is in rest. In this case, it will be changed like in this way. There will be a numerator and a denominator and a constant V will be there. Okay. And what is V? And V is the velocity of sound. So if both the V, in this case, if we leave this equation like this, it will be nu 1 is equal to nu 0. But we will change a little here. Now how will we change it? Let see one thing. Suppose this is the frequency the observer is getting from a source. Okay, and when there is source and here is observer, the observer is receiving this kind of frequency from the source. Now the source start moving toward the observer. What will happen? It will be squeezed like this. So the frequency increased. And what will happen if the source goes away from the observer? If it goes away from the observer, the frequency increases. Here the sound is, sound will be higher frequency, and here the frequency will be decreased. So this is the main funda of the Doppler effect. It is being squeezed. This is source and this is observer, and this is observer, this is source, and it is being stretched when it is moving further. So we need to keep in mind this thing, that when the observer is moving away from the source, or the source is moving away from the observer, the frequency will be lower than the actual frequency. And when they are approaching towards each other, or the source or the observer is coming towards each other, then the frequency will be higher. So we will modify our formula according to that. Now I have written something, that is Vs. It will be the velocity of source, Vo will be the observer velocity, and V is the velocity of sound in air or in that medium. So our source in this equation, always remember, our source will be in the denominator and our observer is always the prime one, which will in the upper position numerator. So when the source is coming towards the observer, there will be increase in the frequency. So to increase this frequency, what we need to do, and the observer velocity is zero, but there is a velocity of source. So there will be velocity of source and observer velocity is zero here. So in between there will be a sign, you will put it. How? As the it is zero, so if we put minus or plus, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. But in the lower, in the denominator, as the frequency is rising, so we need to decrease the denominator to increase the total result. So this will become V by V minus Vs. This will be our frequency formula when the source is coming towards the observer. In the same way, if the observer is going towards the source and source remains at the rest, then we will change it little bit. The main formula is the same, and the observer will be the culprit here. So here it will be plus or minus, and the at the source is zero, so we will put nothing in the denominator. But in the numerator, we need to, as the observer is moving towards the source, so the frequency will again increase like this. So to increase this frequency, we need to increase the numerator, and this will be our formula for the observer moving towards a rest source. Okay. Now, what if the source is moving away from the observer, from the rest observer? This is the situation you can easily assume. Suppose you are standing on a railway station or beside a bus route or a taxi route, and a train passes you or a bus passes you by honking. Then you will listen that the sound of the horn is decreasing as the vehicle is going far. So, but you are still on the platform or beside the road standing. So your velocity or the observer velocity is zero, but the source is moving away from the observer. Then what will be the result? The result will be nothing but the frequency will decrease and the observer is in rest. So we will do nothing with the numerator. The source is moving, so the source is the culprit for changing the frequency. So source will be, we need to decrease this value, so we need to increase that denominator value by this amount. So this is the simple tricks, and this is our formula for source moving away from a rest observer. And this could be, and if we reverse this situation, like the source is there and you are running away from a source, and there is a different many kinds of, suppose there is a theater or there is some program going on in a stage, and you are passing by your motorcycle or a cycle beside that mic. In that situation, as you going far from the mic or the sound box, the frequency will be lower. So in this case, the observer is the culprit in decreasing the frequency. So we will deal with the observer, but source is at rest, so we will do nothing with the source. Okay. So now, as the observer is moving far away and the frequency is decreasing, what we need to do? We need to decrease the numerator. Very simple. So this is our frequency, new frequency for observer moving away from a rest source. Now, in another case, suppose the observer and source both are moving towards themselves, then in both case the observer is moving towards source and the source is moving towards the observer, in the both case the frequency will increase, and both are responsible for increasing the new frequency. So in observer case, if we need to want to increase this amount, we need to increase this, and if we need to increase this amount, we need to decrease this. Very simple, na? And what if the observer is moving away and the source is also moving away? Then nothing, just we will change the sign here, and the answer is in front of us. So for this color the plus sign, and the blue color there is minus sign. You can understand this easily. Now I will discuss in another interesting fact. Suppose there is a situation that is one car is going very fast on a highway, and another car faster than that car is giving blowing the horn and overtakes it. So the rearer car will have the higher velocity, and the car in front of that rear car will have a lower velocity. In that case, the rear car will be, the car from the back side will be act as the source of the sound at it is blowing horn. So in this case what is happening, the source and the observer is moving in the same direction, but the observer has a lower velocity but the source has a higher velocity. In this case what will be our Doppler frequency? Our Doppler frequency will nothing but some simple logic. What observer is moving away from the source, that is it is trying to decrease the frequency. So observer is trying to decrease the frequency and the source is traveling towards the observer, that is it is trying to increase the frequency. So it is trying to increase the frequency and this will be our result. And you can reverse the situation, like the source is traveling towards the observer, is traveling towards the source and source is traveling away from the observer. Then what will be the situation? Observer is trying to increase, so this will be plus, and the source is trying to decrease the frequency, so this will be also plus. So for the blue sign, green sign, the green plus positive sign will be taken here. So split this formula in your copy and write it down separately, that then you can easily understand. So what you can see is the nu 1, nu 0 and the v by v, this and the here v 0 and v s is almost fixed. The change in sign will result in the frequency change. And in this case, suppose the source is moving with the same velocity, suppose 20 km per hour, and the source also moving with 20 km per hour in the same direction, then this V0 and V, this will be equal and both will cancel out and we will get a result of nu 1 is equal to nu 0. That is the no Doppler effect. So this was our Doppler effect for sound waves. Now what are the main uses of Doppler effect that we can use it in our daily life to make it easier our lifestyle? So when a police you can see that there are some speed measuring object or speed measuring screen on the highways these days, by which you can see your vehicle speed when you passes by that screen or some sensors. That sensor uses the Doppler effect to measure your sound, to measure your velocity. What it does is there is a source of sound, ultrasonic or supersonic sound, we cannot hear it. It emits a sound wave and a vehicle moving on a road will be hit by this sound wave, and the sound wave will be reflected back here, and here will be a receiver. So there will be change in the sound wave due to this moving car, and calculating that change we can easily understand or calculate the velocity of that vehicle. And in the cricket field you can use, as soon as a bowler bowls, the speed of the ball pop up in our screen, TV screen. That is also by using a Doppler effect. Scientists also measure some velocity of stars and interstellar objects by using Doppler effect, and doctors use Doppler effect to measure the flow of blood in various parts of human body. And these are the use of Doppler effect. Now we will discuss about the light, Doppler effect in light. So in the Doppler of light, we don't use the word Doppler effect, we use the word Doppler shift. And let's understand this image to understand what is Doppler effect of light or Doppler shift. Suppose this is a source which is moving towards this boy or the observer 1, and it is moving away from the observer 2 or this girl, this beautiful girl. Oh, he is also handsome, by the way. Now we know the Wibgeur, the diffraction of light, Wibgeur order. The red will be at the end and the blue or violet will be on the another end. So when the source is coming towards an observer, towards observer 1, the frequency will be pushed or the shrink like this, and it will be towards the blue region. That is that the wavelength of the blue is lower than that of red. We can see it. So the observer whom towards whom the light is coming, light source is coming, he will or the he will see it a bluish light, and irrespective of the emitting source or emitted frequency, he will observe a bluish light, and this is the blue shift. And when the source is going away from this observer 2, the light, the wavelength or frequency will be stretched, and as it is being stretched, the wavelength is being higher. So red light has a higher wavelength or a lower frequency. So the observer 2 will see a reddish light irrespective of the emitted light. This is known as the red shift. So this picture will clear you the Doppler shift. And where we use this Doppler, red Doppler, it is well to know that when the light source is light source, not the light, when the light source is moving nearly the relative velocity of the light velocity or the very 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 high velocity, then this Doppler shift is being observed. So as we know that our universe is expanding day by day or in every second, every minute, so there are some stars which are going away from our Earth, and there are also some stars which are coming towards our Earth. Maybe they are in far distance, maybe 80-90 light years away. This though this is the very less distance, maybe 100 or 1000 of light years away, they are going towards they are coming towards us, or they are going away from us. So as the stars emits light, they are the light source, and there as they are moving, they are the moving light source. When the stars are moving towards us, there is a bluish light. You can observe in the sky, some stars are bluish and some are reddish. The bluish stars are coming towards us, towards the Earth, and the reddish stars is going away from the Earth. So this is how we can say is that star is coming towards or going away from us. So this is the basic principle of Doppler shift, and there is a formula of Doppler shift which is given as delta nu by nu is equal to minus of B radial by C, where C is the velocity of light. And delta radial, this is the negative sign, and V radial is the velocity correspond to the line joining the velocity component, simply velocity component. Velocity component along line. source and observer. So this is a formula by which we can calculate the shift in the Doppler, that is the Doppler shift, and this is the main funda of light Doppler. Hope you enjoy this class. For today we are ending this video here, and if you like this video, please like our video and comment if there is any question in your doubtful mind. Thank you.